Awesome. Welcome, Jennifer.
Hi, Robin.
Hi. Thanks for joining us and sharing your Psyche journey, which I love your journey.
So, you're welcome. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. So we'll start off, you know, the idea here is for people that have never experienced Psyche or aren't sure about it to hear from a variety of people that have experienced it. So if somebody were to ask you, what is Psyche or how do you define Psyche, how would you let them know or what would you say?
Psyche for me, the overall feeling of Psyche is home. Mm. It's an energetic process that transforms limiting beliefs that are held deep within your subconscious mind. So it makes small changes easier to transform into what you want. And then it also helps you to release stress from any type of situation that you're in within your life.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Sort of everybody needs it, right?
Yeah. Yes, it is.
Especially now.
It is such a great skill to have. I took my basic a little over a year ago, and I still every single day am using Psyche as in some way, shape, or form, because I do feel like it is a skill that would benefit anyone to have, because whatever kind of struggle I am going through in my day-to-day life, it is like I'm never alone, because I have that as a tool to support me for things that I want to create or things that I want to release.
Beautiful. Yeah. Isn't that awesome that you can go either way? I want to release this. I need to, you know, let go of this, or I want to move in that direction. And then you can do the balance.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. So speaking of that, is there anything you want to share about your transformation that maybe you've experienced, whether that's a physical, mental, spiritual, emotional, you know, beautiful story, because I know you have many.
So. Okay. So do we have about an hour? Because I could just go on and on. So one of the biggest things that changed for me in my life was I already had a transformational journey before coming to Psyche. I'm a stage 3 thyroid cancer survivor. And then before I had come to Psyche, in the year prior, I had put multiple autoimmune diseases, including rheumatoid arthritis, into remission using nutrition. But along that process of healing using food, I became ultra hypersensitive and fearful around eating. Mm. I couldn't go to a restaurant if I had never been there. Even communicating with a server and specifically telling them what my nutritional needs were, because I was diagnosed a year before that as celiac. Mm-hmm. To be able to go out in that kind of situation was very stressful. Even going over my mom's house, I would be afraid that she would use the wrong kind of oil. And I don't even know what I was afraid of. But through Psyche, I have completely cleared my phobia of food. I can eat out at any restaurant, anytime. I can communicate with them what my needs are. And along the process, I have actually removed my gluten sensitivity.
Wow.
Yeah. So I ate an entire piece of toast one day for breakfast out at a restaurant, no effects whatsoever. And it's changed my life to not be so fearful around food.
Absolutely. Beautiful. Thank you. Can you, and the energy that now is open to do other things, like all that energy that was fearful energy. Now you can use it for more.
And it really just, I am like, I love food. Cooking is my life, and it's fueled my creativity as well. Not having that fear and feeling like, oh, I have to make sure that there's 7 meals prepped in the fridge because I might run out of food and then I might not have anything. So now it's just like everything is more in flow.
Yeah. Yeah. Beautiful. I love that. Freed up your creativity. Absolutely. Absolutely. So you attended the basic workshop, and, you know, how kind of twofold. One is, how do you find out about Psyche? And then more importantly, What doubts or questions or thoughts did you have prior to coming to the workshop?
Okay, so I have been working with a therapist for many years, and I took the basic in October of 2019, and she took the basic in, I believe, August. So I was her first practice student outside of the basic.
Right.
So that's how I found out about Psyche. And before that, her and I had been working so much with learning and reading Bruce Lipton's books and lectures and stuff like that. So I was already familiar with it. And after that first balance that she did with me, I said to her, "Oh, I'm going to do this. How are we going to figure out how I'm going to pay for it?" And she worked with me to try to figure out how we were going to pay for it. And within 3 months, I attended the basic.
Wow.
And as far as hesitation goes, I had none.
Mm-hmm.
Once I tried it that first time, that was it. I knew that it was something that I was supposed to do. I was something I was supposed to learn for myself and potentially learn to help other people. Mm-hmm. It just, from that one balance, it changed my perspective of everything.
Right. Beautiful. Beautiful. Yeah. It shifts about what's possible when you do that. And what I love is that you experienced it first and then came to the workshop, and other people just hear about the workshop, don't have the opportunity to experience it and come to the workshop. But the connection is they know it's right for them, or there's got an inkling inside that says, go do this, you know, which you got very strongly.
So. Yes, yes.
Awesome, good. And what, if anything, have you found challenging about Psyche?
The only challenging part that I have found is really, it's taking me a long time to be able to verbally communicate what it is to other people and have them. I struggle with that. That is the only thing.
Mm-hmm.
Everything that I learned in the actual basic workshop about the process and how to use it, from the day that I stepped out of the workshop, it became part of who I was.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I sleep with the binder underneath my bed.
Pull it out whenever you need.
Yep, it's always there. And I mean, at this point, I don't need the binder anymore for the most part, but it's always there if there's one of those weird little times where you need it.
Right, exactly. Beautiful, beautiful. So yeah, the describing of it is often a challenge for people, because it can apply to so much, and it's got, you know, we teach it in 3 days. So obviously it's not a half an hour workshop,
right,
where it's, you know, it has one line explanation. And what we want to do is, and you've got the experience now that you can find the words because you've had your own experience, and people, what they really want is to know there's a possibility that they could change. They have, you know, we give them hope that something can, that it's possible. And
yes,
finding those words is what.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I think that might be part of, it might also partly be because I really do believe I was supposed to take the year that I took from the course of that year to heal myself.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe that's the reason that I couldn't communicate it properly is because I wasn't ready to yet. When I became ready to, when you asked me, I can tell you clearly what it is. And now I can talk to people about what it is.
Right.
So
I
it's
think
like
that's great insight, Jennifer.
Thank you.
You know, it was time, it was an opportunity for you to do that inside work. And then the external words flow once you've done your inside work. So
yes.
And I know you've done a lot. So
yeah.
Yeah. So is there anything else you want to just share in general, or something else about your experience with the journey?
There's two other things.
Mm-hmm.
The one big change that I had so many changes that I just would love to share with everyone. But one of the other big changes is that I really became a witness to my own thoughts, whereas before I was controlled by my thoughts.
Oh, that's a great way to put it.
I would have obsessive compulsive thinking about problems and issues in my life. And now I can witness them and move past and see what the situation is like at face value instead of just bringing all that stress and fear into my life.
That's beautiful.
And then the other exciting thing was that over the course, so I've talked about writing a book or publishing a blog since, I don't know, way before my weight loss journey, because I didn't mention this. I've also lost 125 pounds along the process of my healing. And I've been talking about writing a book or writing a blog for a decade. And I finally, 1 year, on the 1 year anniversary of my Psych-K was when my blog was published. So now I have that up and running and I'm sharing all of my, I'm still eating gluten-free, even though I have healed from that. It's still how I choose to eat.
Right.
And I'm promoting cooking and eating a whole food lifestyle, which I really believe supports all of what we do here. Mm-hmm. They're all tied together.
Yeah, it is. We're not separate. We're all a holistic
being. Yes. Yes.
And, you know, and I love that. Even though you know you can eat gluten, you're choosing not to. So it gives you that choice rather than the fear of avoiding. It's like, well, I could if I want to, but I really don't want to.
Right. And so for someone who struggles with that, you're constantly afraid that someone's going to use the wrong knife, use mm-hmm. the wrong cutting board to serve your food when you're out in a restaurant.
Right.
And to be able to remove that, that transformed my life.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And that's part of why Psych-K fits into my vision for what I think with food and health and lifestyle changes. And I named my blog Small Changes Add Up because I think it encompasses all of it. Encompasses Psych-K, encompasses food, it encompasses all health and wellness.
Right. That's beautiful. Okay. So give us the website access to your blog.
Oh, sure. It's smallchangesaddup.com.
Smallchangesaddup.com.
Yes.
Awesome. All right. So go there and read wonderful things that Jennifer's teaching us. So Jennifer,
that's a gluten-free, sugar-free baking recipes and fun stuff.
I'm going pretty soon. I'll come on. So thank you, Jennifer, very much for sharing your journey. And I look forward to continuing our connection.
Oh, thank you so much, Robin. It was so nice connecting with you today.
Yeah, good. Thank you.